happened. Since the beginning, our primary goal has been to remind New Bordeaux about the reality outside your door, outside your neighborhood, to remind you that we are a city. And when one of us is wrong, all of us are wrong. When one of us is misrepresented, we all misrepresent it. None of us know how long we've got. So we best make good use of right now. And right now, I want to talk to the young bloods out there. These words I'm laying out are for the teenagers, college students, our next generation of leaders. Those unfortunate folks out there, us old fuckers, are leaving behind to clean up all the shit we've been piling up. First of all, let me apologize. We're not leaving this country or this planet in a better condition than when we slid out our mouths. But we tried. At least some of us did. Goddamn, did we try. No fucking day. Sure, things ain't exactly as bad as they used to be, but here's the truth. I want my country to be a better place than it is. I want to believe that this country is capable of leading by example, that we're willing to hold ourselves to a higher set of standards, face the consequences when we fall short. I want to believe all those things.
Is he dead?
Yeah, he's dead. Him and Georgie both.
It's the best news I've heard in ages. Can we get an amen, Padre?
So, what happens now?
What do you mean, what happens now? It's over, done, finished.
I ain't talking to you. Just 'cause Sal Marcano's dead, Lincoln, doesn't mean it's over. Now, what you did and the size of it all, you created a storm in this here city, and it's gonna take a long time for it to dissipate, if it ever does.
With Marcano dead, New Bordeaux belongs to me. Ain't nobody left to stand in my way.
You can't be serious. The point of this wasn't to replace Marcano, it was to remove him. This city's done gone through enough. It doesn't need another Sal Marcano.
This city? You've got to be fucking kidding me. This city is a cesspool. It's where people come to fuck and drink and get high.
You watch your filthy mouth.
It's what the city is, Padre. If it's not given another Sal Marcano, it's gonna shit one out.
He's right. If it ain't gonna be me, it's gonna be somebody else. Probably somebody worse.
Amen.
Thank you. You remember what you told me when you came back from the war? How you wanted to go to California? Leave all this behind? And just start all over?
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, it ain't too late, Lincoln. You can still go. Go! And don't look back.
Listen, I'd love to stay here and debate the merits of one crime boss over another, but I've got a schedule to keep. Bit of advice, though. The scumbags you've been working with, kill them. All of them. Bury them before they bury you, buddy. Oh. I'll be seeing you, Padre.
God forgive me for standing by you through all this, Lincoln. But if you do anything except leave, we're finished. You hear?
Bob.
A man's soul can only carry so much. And mine is on the verge of breaking.
Kennedy's. This is New Bordeaux News. The police and fire department are still combing through the wreckage of the unlicensed casino complex under development in the northern unincorporated section of New Bordeaux. Details remain sketchy, but police discovered multiple bodies in what was clearly a gun battle with an unknown number of assailants at the planned resort. Convicted felon Salvatore Marcano and his son Georgie have been identified among the dead. Listeners may recall the ongoing initiative to legalize gambling in New Bordeaux, which was unable to pass a city council vote. More recently, the measure was headed before the circuit court for review. However, the apparent assassination of sitting Judge Cornelius Holden has stalled proceedings. We'll keep you updated with more details of this breaking story.
After Lincoln vanished, Vito Scaletta took over the city. I spit on Sal Marcano's grave one last time by actually doing what Marcano couldn't, finishing the casino. Now, 2 years later, Scaletta opened another casino, and then it was just an avalanche of development. Hotels, arenas, the new convention center. I mean, today everyone knows this place as the Las Vegas of the South, but the whole damn thing was built on bodies Lincoln Clay left behind with blood money he and his lieutenants stole from the mob. And Vito? He still lives in that penthouse at the top of Marcano's casino, looking out over the city he owns. After Sal Marcano's death, Lincoln Clay disappeared. The Bureau deprioritized the investigation after a few months, but I keep an active file. In 1971, I tracked him to a California shipyard where he was working under an assumed name. By the time we got there, though, he was gone. The trail went cold, and by 77, 78, I figured he was dead. But then I got a report of someone matching his description working with the Colombians. Since then, there's a new sighting of him every couple of years.
Lincoln made it out to California. Worked at the shipyards for a few years. Met him a woman. Seemed like he was gonna get married, but then it all came apart. Don't know why. He started moving around. He went to Alaska, New York, South America. He even went back to Vietnam. I I still get postcards from time to time. You know, I think Lincoln wasn't able to accept the world for what it is, or his place in it.
Someday, he's going to get tired of running, or make a mistake. And I'll be waiting. I promise you that.
Hold my hand.
Let me ask you something. Senator! Where were you when John Fitzgerald Kennedy was assassinated?
I don't remember. At home, I believe.
I don't remember. At home, I believe.
Let me tell you where I was. A muddy hut in Vietnam. Slowly dismembering an old woman, cutting her apart bit by bit. And do you know why? Because her son was an NVA officer. And hurting her was the only way to make him talk.
I don't understand what this has to do
with... What he told us saved the lives of an entire platoon. That's 42 men. Men that lived another day because I was willing to take a saw to that old woman.
Thank you, Mr. Donovan. I believe that...
Sit down and shut the fuck up! I did a lot of terrible shit over there. In the name of this country. Shit that will haunt me for the rest of my life. But I did it because I believed in the fight. I believed what this nation stood for. So, to be sitting there ass deep in mud with that old woman scattered all around me, and hearing that the President of the United States had just been fucking murdered? Well, I knew right then and there that I couldn't let that stand. That I would find a way to make it right, no matter how long it took.
What are you saying?
I'm saying that Sal Marcano and a group of conspirators murdered Jack Kennedy.
Oh, that is the most absurd thing I have ever heard.
I assumed you would say that.
Don't fucking move! You're out of your mind.
Oh, I don't hold anyone's ambitions against them, Senator. And you certainly were ambitious, weren't you? You went to law school, and then you became a district attorney, and then United States Senate. After Sal Marcano died, I went through his files. Imagine my surprise when I saw your name over and over and over and over again! The mob wanted Jack Kennedy dead, and you were more than willing to help.
There are cameras everywhere. There's witnesses.
No, I want
you
them
never
to
get
see
away
that,
with this.
You stupid asshole, because then they will know that I am not finishing with you. I am starting with you. Oh, and they're next. Gentlemen,
God,
Sal and Georgie are gone. And after all the shit we've been through, we run this city.
After all the bullshit, it's almost impossible for me to wrap my brain around the fact that we actually did it. You're a fucking saint, Lincoln. And I'm honored to know you.
It ain't personal. What in the fuck?
You want to know what happened to Lincoln? After he killed those people he worked with, I realized that he was no different from Sal Marcano. So I put a bomb under his car.
The things he did, that what he turned into. I couldn't. I did some things in my life. Things that I regret. But killing Lincoln Clay isn't one of them. He carved his path out all on his own.
After everything he did, all the people he killed? No, no. The car bomb was too quick, too clean. You know, sometimes I wonder, that priest, Father James Ballard, he identified the body. Some nights when I'm down here, going over it all again, I swear I hear footsteps upstairs. It sounds like combat boots. Now, I know it's just this old house creaking and moaning. Well, when it happens, I can't help but wonder if it's Lincoln Clay coming to take what's left of my life.